Hello everyone, in our previous video, we explored the various test methods for infinite series, and today we'll look at the limit comparison test. Like the other test we've learned, there are conditions for using the limit comparison test. To remember these conditions easily, let's insert three red p's in between. Here, p signifies positive, and it means that a sub n must be positive, b sub n must also be positive, and finally, the limit of a sub n over b sub n must also be positive. Let's remember these three positive conditions well, and we'll delve into what the limit comparison test is all about. If a sub n is greater than 0 and b sub n is greater than 0, and as n approaches to infinity, the limit of a sub n over b sub n is a positive and finite, denoted by some value L, then the infinite series of a sub n and b sub n either both converge or both diverge. This means that we can determine the convergence or divergence of a given series by comparing it with another series whose convergence or divergence we already know. Let's take a closer look at why this is the case. Since we define L as a positive and finite, we can find two finite and positive numbers, A and B, such that L is greater than A and less than B. As N approaches to infinity, the limit of A sub N over B sub N becomes L, implying that for sufficiently large N, A sub N over B sub N must be close to L. Therefore, there exists a positive integer capital N such that a sub n over b sub n is greater than capital A and less than capital B for n is greater than or equals to capital N. Now let's multiply both sides of the inequality by b sub n. Since b sub n is positive, we have a sub n is greater than capital A times b sub n and less than capital B times b sub n. And applying the sigma notation to each term of the inequality, we obtain the inequality as shown on the screen. Since capital A and capital B are constants, they are placed outside the sigma notation. We'll now use the direct comparison test learned in previous video to prove the limit comparison test. For better understanding, I recommend watching the direct comparison test video, the link to which is provided in the upper right corner. Let's assume that the sum of b sub n on the left diverges to infinity. Then the left side becomes a times infinity, which diverges to infinity. Consequently, the sum of a sub n must be greater than infinity, leading to divergence. Now, let's assume that the sum of b sub n on the right converges to some positive constant value, let's say k. Then the right side of the inequality becomes capital B times k. The sum of a sub n must be smaller than an arbitrary constant value b times k, indicating convergence. To use the limit comparison test, we need a second series, which is obtained by disregarding all but the highest powers of n in both the numerator and the denominator of the given problem. Let's look at a few examples together. Here we have an infinite sum of 1 over 3n squared minus 5n plus 7. Keeping the highest power in the numerator as it is, we focus on the denominator, removing all terms except the highest power term, which is n squared. This gives us the second series we need, which is the infinite sum of 1 over n squared. Let's consider a more complex problem this time. The highest power in the numerator is n squared, and the denominator is n to the power 5. So we can express the series as n squared over n to the power 5, which simplifies to 1 over n to the power 3. Let's now consider the infinite sum of 5 over square root 3n plus 1. The highest power in the numerator is 1, and in the denominator, it is square root n. Therefore, the second series we need to compare with is the infinite sum of 1 over square root n. Once we've found the second series, we can use the limit comparison test to determine whether the infinite sum on the left converges or diverges. Shall we work on the problem together? Here we have the infinite sum of 1 over 2 to the power of n minus n as our first problem. We'll take only the highest powers from the numerator and denominator to use the infinite sum of 1 over 2 to the power of n as our second comparison series. Now, let's find the limit of the ratio of these two sequences. As it approaches to infinity, the limit of 1 over 2 to the power of n minus n over 1 over 2 to the power of n simplifies the limit of 2 to the power of n over 2 to the power of n minus n. By multiplying 1 over 2 to the power of n to both the numerator and denominator, we can simplify the expression to the limit of 1 over 1 minus n over 2 to the power of n. As n approaches to infinity, n over 2 to the power of n approaches 0, so this limit becomes 1. Now, let's check if the three conditions of the limit comparison test are satisfied. Both the sequence of the problem, 1 over 2 to the power of n minus n, and the comparison series, 1 over 2 to the power of n, are always positive for n greater than or equal to 1. And the limit we found is also positive. Therefore, all three conditions are met. Hence, the two series either both converge or both diverge. Since the infinite sum of 1 over 2 to the power of n is a geometric series with a common ratio of half, and this common ratio is less than 1, it converges. Therefore, 1 over 2 to the power of n minus n also converges. Here is our second example. The infinite sum of 3n squared plus 4n over square root 6 plus n to the power of 5. Taking only the highest powers from the numerator and the denominator, the second comparison series becomes n squared over square root n to the power of 5. Expressing it as n squared over n to the power of 5 over 2, then multiplying both the numerator and denominator by n to the power of negative 2 simplifies it to 1 over n to the power of half, the infinite sum of which is 1 over square root n. Now, let's find the limit using this sequence. Simplify the expression of the ratio of 3n squared plus 4n over square root 6 plus n to the power of 5 over 1 over square root n. We can rewrite it as 3n squared plus 4n over square root 6 plus n to the power of 5 times square root n. When you simplify the expression, it becomes the limit of 3n squared plus 4n times square root n over square root 6 plus n to the power of 5. And multiplying both the numerator and the denominator by square root n, the expression becomes the limit of 3n squared plus 4n times n over square root 6n plus n to the power of 6. Expanding the numerator, we get 3n to the power of 3 plus 4n squared over square root 6n plus n to the power of 6. And by multiplying both the numerator and denominator by 1 over n to the power of 3, we get 3 plus 4 over n over square root 6 over n to the power of 5 plus 1. As n approaches infinity, the denominator's 6 over n to the power of 5 approaches 0, and the numerator's 4 over n also approaches 0. So the limit becomes 3. Now, let's check if the conditions for the limit comparison test are satisfied. First, the sequence given in the problem is always positive, as is our second comparison sequence. Finally, the limit we found is also positive. Therefore, we can use the limit comparison test, and since our comparison sequence 1 over square root n diverges, the problem we solve also diverges. The reason for the divergence of the infinite sum of 1 over square root n can be understood using the p-series test, as the value of p is less than or equals to 1. You can refer to the related video in the top right corner. Today, we learned about the limit comparison test. Remember the three conditions that need to be satisfied. And if you can find the right comparison series, it won't be difficult. In the next video, we'll learn about alternating series. If today's video was helpful, please like and subscribe. Thank you for watching, and until next time, I've been your math guardian, Alex.